My name is Amanda Mudra. I'm a senior aerospace engineer at Wichita State University. This year, I'm a part of a team in the senior capstone course where we are competing in the Bronze Propeller competition held every year, hosted by Boeing, where we design, build, and fly an RC aircraft. My team has to build this aircraft in a certain amount of time, and that time does go towards our score. Our plane is completely designed by me and my team members. We focused a lot on ease of manufacturing. We found that was going to put us ahead of all of the other teams if we pushed for a really low assembly time and a really low weight. The build was heavily practiced, I'll say that. We were pushing for that 30-minute or under mark. One of the bigger issues that we faced at that point was nerves. We had been practicing everything, but we didn't anticipate how nervous we would be, how much our hands would shake, putting glue on, applying the skin to our aircraft, putting pieces together even. I don't think any of us anticipated how much harder that would make the build. There was a lot of hiccups that compounded on each other. Fortunately, we were able to kind of work through it. We had talked through what some issues could be and brainstormed ideas on how to fix those, and I'm glad that my team was able to do that. After we have finished our assembly, we will be wind tunnel testing our aircraft that we have designed. We'll be testing to make sure that we're hitting the correct loads that we anticipated. We're essentially verifying all of our engineering work we did in the fall. After wind tunnel testing, we'll have first flight day. So we have a nice RC pilot. He's a friend of Dr. Miller's. He comes down and he flies all of the planes that the teams build. Once he flies our aircraft, he's actually able to give us a lot of feedback on how our plane flies. So when we wind tunnel test, we get some data from it, but having that real-time feel from the pilot himself gives us a lot more accurate description on how our plane is behaving and what might need to change and what it is that we can change. I'm a part of the NASA Jumpstart program. I've been working with Dr. Miller for 3.5 years now. The NASA Jumpstart program is actually a very unique experience at Wichita State. It's one of the big reasons that I stuck with aerospace. I was able to get into this program fairly early on as a freshman. They love to encourage people that have no experience, little experience. Through the NASA Jumpstart program, I was able to rebuild Wichita State's water tunnel facility. I took it apart and rebuilt it over the course of about a year or so. It's a massive, massive project to take on as a freshman. Some of the other projects that I've done with the NASA Jumpstart program, I work in the Projects and Prototyping Lab in the John Barber Center. Essentially, I have a hands-on approach with the Senior Design Capstone course for aerospace. I get to help seniors modify their designs, manufacture, give them techniques and tips. I also provide them with their materials and I cut out their pieces on our laser cutter. I help them with 3D printing, foam cutting, any of the equipment we have downstairs. So I'm pretty well informed on the manufacturing side of building RC planes. It's kind of my specialty. Wichita State has a lot of industry ties, especially to the aerospace community. I definitely stumbled into the right major there. And I kind of am happy that my passions ended up lining up with the major that I chose. I also got a scholarship. I'm a Wallace Scholar. So my team actually is called the McWallace team. Four of us are Wallace Scholars and one of us is a McGregor Scholar. So we kind of knew each other already from being in the same receptions and seeing each other all the time. And it was definitely a good incentive to come here because I wasn't too worried about having to find a job to support my way through, having to rely on my parents too much. After graduating, I'll be a flight test engineer for Lockheed Martin, working on C-130s out in Georgia. A lot of hands-on in-flight testing. I'm very excited to see where that's going to take me.